Hi everyone. Welcome to today's webinar. We're going to give a few minutes for folks to continue to trickle in. So if you're already on the call, hang tight. We'll get started in a few minutes. You've just joined. We are waiting for a little bit more of the audience to roll in, so hang tight. We'll get started in just a couple minutes. We've got a few people on the call, but not too many, so we'll keep giving it just a minute, and then we'll get started. All right, we do have a packed agenda, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started. Hello everyone, my name is Axel Pearson, coming to you live from snowy Park City, Utah. Welcome to the Integrated Lighting Campaign's Recognition Opportunities for Participants webinar. Thank you for joining. Thank you to the many of you that have already been involved with the campaign. For those of you that are new, welcome. Today, we'll learn how to access practical resources, gain access to some technical assistance and guidance, and receive recognition for your advanced lighting projects. Today, I'll tell you about some new recognition categories that we have that weren't there last year, and I'll explain how to successfully submit your project for recognition. But first, let's start with some introductions. Next slide, please. As I mentioned, I am Axel Pearson, the project manager at Pacific Northwest National Laboratory, yours truly over on the left there. I will be your presenter today. And while you'll hear mostly my voice, I assure you there is a dedicated team of professionals and lighting nerds working together to make this year's campaign a success. My colleagues Sergey Gorbachuk and Michael Meyer are here with me today behind the scenes, monitoring your comments and questions that might come in during the webinar. So feel free to send them whatever questions you may have throughout the webinar. We did intentionally leave some time at the end for Q&A and some opportunity for discussion if you'd like at the end of the webinar. So when that rolls around, I will take a moment to look at the chat pane that I've got up on my other screen. I will read the questions that come in and I will do my best to answer them. If I can't answer them, I will look to some support from Michael Meyer, and if he can't answer it well, we might be in trouble. We'll do some digging and get back to you after the webinar. Also, if you have technical difficulties, send them in the chat as well. Someone will be there behind the scenes, maybe Sergey, and they will help you figure that out. So don't be afraid to use that question and answer pane for that as well. Last but not least, we have some of our ILC organizers here today with us, and I've invited them to talk a bit about their organizations and how they align with the campaign. I will introduce each of them in just a moment. First, we have some announcements. So next slide. So these are some upcoming events that you might be interested in. We'll send these slides out, so you'll have the slides and you'll be able to click these links to register and learn more. First up, NALMCO, who is one of our organizing committee members, is holding their spring seminar in early March in person in Florida. So check that event out. There are also a couple webinars focused on the Building Envelope campaign of the Better Buildings program, which is just like the ILC, as the name sounds, focused on the building envelope, but similar campaign. So those will be March 2nd and April 6th. In fact, I have a slide next telling you a little bit more about that campaign, the Building Envelope campaign. Sorry, not quite ready for the next slide. Thanks. Sorry, I know I said next slide. So next up, we have a joint webinar with the Better Buildings Plug Loads team on systems integration and improving plug load management, enabling whole building controls and increased energy savings. So you can join us for that webinar as we learn about how the Minnesota Department of Transportation accomplished plug load controls integration with occupancy sensors. Actually, we recognized the Minnesota DOT for this last year in the ILC campaign. Also on that webinar, the University of California, San Diego is integrating plug load controls with their building management systems. And they're also their occupancy data system. So don't miss that webinar if you're interested in integrating lighting and plug loads. That's going to be pretty exciting. Okay, finally, the Better Buildings, Better Plants Summit will be held in May this year. The summit provides an opportunity for professionals to explore emerging technologies and share innovative strategies in energy efficiency, decarbonization, and water and waste reduction. Attendees take part in interactive sessions with industry experts and market leaders, as well as multiple opportunities to network with peers. So the 2022 summit takes place May 17th to 19th this year in person in Washington, D.C. Okay, next slide. All right, before we get steeped into lighting and controls, I want to take a minute to tell you about our sister program, the Building Envelope Campaign. Was launched in June 2020. In its first year, they recognized 14 buildings with high-performing envelopes that accounted for savings of almost 9 million kBTUs per year based on envelope upgrades alone. The submission deadline for this year is Friday, April 8th. And new this year is the potential for a project to be recognized as an equity role model and have a carbon savings estimator that has been added to the tool. So for more information, please visit their website or email envelopecampaign@ornl.gov. Right. Next slide. Okay, so I've talked about a couple campaigns, the ILC, the Building Envelope Campaign. If you're not familiar with the campaign, this should help. This is some campaign basics. Better Buildings technology campaigns are collaborative platforms designed to help speed the adoption of promising energy savings technologies through providing resources helpful to decision makers as well as technical assistance and recognizing exemplary projects that lead the way. In 2019, participants of several campaigns reported energy savings totaling more than $250 million resulting from the adoption of these energy savings technologies. So as you can see on this slide, we follow a handy formula: resources plus technical assistance plus recognition equals accelerated adoption. So this is really our goal here with integrated lighting, to provide those resources and technical assistance, recognize again these exemplary projects. And that really, we've found, helps accelerate the adoption of these new technologies. And of course, today we are talking about integrated lighting. Before we get to that, I want to have a poll. So next slide. I want to get to know you all on the call. So a poll just popped up on your screen. If you don't mind, please answer it. Which of the following sector categories most accurately describes your organization? Give just another 10 or 15 seconds so to make sure, in case you're thinking about this one, but it'll be pretty easy. Okay, let's go ahead and close that one. Okay, there we go. There are the responses. 75% of us, commercial real estate and hospitality, and a quarter government. Great. Thank you. Great. Next slide. So we have some wonderful folks working with us on the campaign who we call organizers or the ILC Organizing Committee. They are our primary planning and management team partners. They help provide guidance for the ILC. They support our outreach efforts, and each of their organizations has an alignment with and interest in the integrated lighting campaign. So those committee members are Better Buildings, which is an initiative of the U.S. Department of Energy, my good friends over at the Design Lights Consortium, the United States General Services Administration, or GSA, the Illuminating Engineering Society, or IES, the International Facilities Management Association, or IFMA, the Lighting Controls Association, LCA, and the International Association of Lighting Management Companies, or NALMCO. So we really appreciate their support. Like I said, some of them are here with us today to introduce their organizations and the value that ILC brings to their organization and their members and other stakeholders. So first up, I would like to introduce Jeff Wanner, a technical project engineer working with the United States Department of Energy to provide the DOE and Better Buildings perspective regarding the ILC. So next slide. And Jeff, I'll let you take it away.
Thanks. First off, thanks Axel and the ILC team for their work. And we can jump to the next slide. Building Technologies Office, so the Department of Energy is proud to sponsor and organize Integrated Lighting Campaign. The Building Technologies Office, which is where I sit, of DOE invests in energy efficiency and related technologies to improve residential and commercial buildings in terms of affordability, comfort, efficiency, and sustainability. We support those goals through early stage investment in R&D, technology validations, and bolstering market integration opportunities. Supporting a broad acceptance via code adoption and technical analysis towards standardization. The integrated lighting campaign falls squarely into the middle bin with an emphasis on fostering technology to market and gaining traction. We can go to the next slide. The Better Buildings Administration or Better Buildings Initiative, which Axel brought up, is a broad initiative across Department of Energy to highlight market leaders and amplify lessons learned throughout many of the building categories. To name a few, office, government, healthcare, industrial, and residential buildings are all various categories. We help them achieve the energy, carbon, and waste, water, and sustainability goals through this campaign. For those that aren't aware, Better Buildings is a voluntary and free public-private partnership. And working towards these goals is supported by highlighting leaders who choose to volunteer to be part of Better Buildings, providing robust information and resources, expanding our energy efficiency workforce, and also highlighting innovative and emerging technologies. Efforts like the Integrated Lighting Campaign work with the Better Buildings Network to build those pathways towards building owners' goals. Better Buildings Technology Campaign contributes to the idea that new technologies and new ideas are key to building a stronger US economy. Next slide. Some results to date. Better Buildings partners with organizations who want to set energy and carbon goals. Throughout the Better Buildings Challenge and the Better Buildings Climate Challenge and lighting and campaigns like this lighting campaign and the envelope campaign. We partner with organizations such as yourselves, as well as building owners and operators who want to focus on specific technologies areas, including integrated lighting and the envelope campaign. To date, we've saved 1.8 quadrillion BTUs and $11 billion across all of our partnerships within Better Buildings. And integrated lighting is going to be very key to pushing these goals much further. Currently, less than 1% of lighting systems in the U.S. are capable of communicating with other building systems. And pushing that more broadly is necessary to reach overarching goals. And a cumulative 16 quadrillion BTUs of energy savings is a goal by 2035. I should also highlight that a large focus of DOE moving forward is energy justice, diversity, equity, and inclusion. And we strongly support efforts like Integrated Lighting Campaign to recognize supporters who are working on projects and making impacts in that growing space. We invite you as participants to come and help support this campaign and to spread the word and to get folks excited about investing in integrated lighting solutions. And feel free to reach out with me to any questions. Thank you. I'll turn it back to Axel now.
Awesome. Thank you, Jeff. Thank you for DOE's support and the Better Buildings Initiative. Okay, next slide. And I'd like to introduce Bill Conley, National Manager of Facility Services with Yamaha Motor Company, representing the International Facility Management Association, or IFMA. Bill, take it away.
Thanks, Axel. Next slide, please, Dana. So IFMA is an international organization. We offer global standards and we're recognized worldwide. We have over 23,000 members in 112 different countries. And we feel that the ILC not only gives good resources to people here in the United States, but we think that a lot of the lessons are applicable across around the world universally. So we are trying to expand this the type of outreach. We have events and conferences where we do sessions, educational sessions. I've partnered with PNNL a couple of times to give presentations on the Integrated Lighting Campaign. And we also have vendors that show up that, you know, show new technology in lighting and stuff like that. We have professional advancement. One of our credentials is the Sustainability Facility Professional, which is aimed at running operations more efficiently and better for the environment. And we supply knowledge and information. We have a resource library where a lot of the ILC information resides. Next slide, please. So we feel that facility managers are probably responsible for most of the lighting in commercial and industrial buildings. So the ILC is definitely geared for them. We manage more than 78 billion square feet of property. We spend over $526 billion a year annually. Our focus is the triple bottom line, especially with the SFP. And IFMA, since about 2001, has really been pushing sustainability for our members and stuff like that, and then carrying the messages such like the Better Building Alliance and the ILC transferred over to us. The ILC influence, we have the resources and guidance and technical advice for IFMA members, again, worldwide. IFMA is involved because of the large market of professionals upon which we can target. And we feel that this could make an appreciable difference in the energy consumption here in the United States, and again, universally. I'd also like to add my own personal side to this. As an organizer, I help with the guidance of the ILC, but also I served as a participant. And based on the guidance and resources that the ILC provided me, two of my facilities were recognized for lighting and integration efficiency. So it's a double-edged sword for me. I benefit from both sides of the equation. So that's it, Axel.
Awesome. Thank you, Bill. And thanks for your participation in both the organizing committee and as a participant. Okay, next slide. And last but not least, Mark Lean is the Industry Relations Manager for the Illuminating Engineering Society. And will tell us a bit about the IES and what they've got going on at the moment and how it relates to ILC. Mark.
Thank you, Axel. I appreciate it. The IES, and we can move on in the slides there. The IES is proudly involved with the ILC as part of our commitment to maximize the energy efficiency of lighting while maintaining lighting quality. And by quality, I'm talking safety, security, performance, aesthetics, and health. So it's a big task, and we, along with ASHRAE, jointly published the 90.1 energy standard, and the International Green Conservation Code with a number of other partners. And we're active with the IECC, the International Energy Conservation Code, the Achieving Zero Energy Design Guides from the Advanced Energy Design Guide Group, and we co-sponsor with the DOE the annual solid state lighting workshops. And the ILC substantiates actual savings. That's a critical piece to understanding and influencing how the marketplace addresses energy use. So you can see on the slides a lot of data here, but I'll just add a comment. If you're involved in the lighting community, the membership in the IES, it's your best investment for knowledge, growth, and networking. Your membership expands your influence on and awareness of lighting standards, educational opportunities, research, and advocacy for quality lighting. Memberships range from $25 a year for students to $200 with sustaining member options for companies. And I can't think of a better return on an investment for anyone involved in our lighting community, especially if you choose to be actively engaged. And you can see a couple of our timely documents. The RP45 is on horticultural lighting. And we also have a new standard coming out on light and health to address circadian lighting. And with that, I'll turn it back to you, Axel.
Hey, thank you, Mark. And thanks to all of our ILC organizers. Hey, next slide. So just like the name sounds, the Integrated Lighting Campaign recognizes installations of integrated lighting, which means that the lighting system can communicate with other building systems to enhance the building's performance. So today's lighting has come a long way from basic LED retrofits. It can talk with the rest of the building to achieve those deeper energy savings at the building level. For example, exchanging information with the HVAC systems and controllable plug loads. Lighting and lighting controls hold some valuable real estate in the building ceilings, and they have the ability to relay that really useful information to other systems like occupancy information, ambient light, temperature and humidity, or location of assets. The list goes on. And while an integrated system's energy benefits often result in a good return on investment in the form of reduced energy costs, it's the non-energy benefits that might tap into a higher value proposition and further tip the scale in favor of adoption of these systems. If you're not familiar with that term, non-energy benefits is kind of a catch-all that covers all of those benefits these systems can bring outside of saved kilowatt hours. An example of a non-energy benefit is space utilization that leverages the lighting system's occupancy sensors can give building managers information for optimizing space layout. For example, a retail location might use it to better organize their store and highlight certain areas of the store or certain products or optimize the path that people can take through the store. And this is just what Walgreens did. It was one of our 2021 recognized participants. Or as you'll hear about in a few slides, Massport use their lighting fixtures as Wi-Fi access points, building their IoT network and helped improve logistics around their shipping yard. Again, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about Massport in a few slides. But I want to be clear too that's not all the campaign is interested in. Certainly integrated lighting is the focus, but there are still luminaires and luminaire control systems that we're hoping to capture as well. Advanced systems and controls in lighting that help improve lighting performance definitely are of interest, and we would love to hear how systems are going above and beyond simple occupancy or daylight or scheduling approaches. In particular, installations where sensors and controls are enabling those deeper operational savings in lighting applications or really improving the occupant experience. And that could be luminaire level lighting controls known as LLLC or white tunable lighting systems that might have a positive effect on the occupant's circadian system. So through the ILC, we hope to learn about and recognize some of these innovative lighting projects, as well as recognize the supporters that help get them there. Slide. So speaking of the recognition, these are the categories of recognitions for those innovative and advanced lighting projects. There are six major categories, two of which are new this year. So starting on the left, there's the advanced use of sensors and controls for lighting, like connected lighting systems or networks lighting controls or LLLC or those white tunable systems I just mentioned. Moving on from the left, there are three separate categories for integrated lighting systems. There's integrated controls for plug loads, for HVAC, and other systems. And again, these are categories that look for projects where the lighting system helps inform those other building systems. When it comes to integrating with those other systems and lighting, there are so many possibilities, like lighting systems that interact with automatic shades or solar PV to optimize, you know, the energy consumed during the day from the sun, the security systems or the Wi-Fi and IoT, like I mentioned. So definitely sky is the limit, really, with those other integrated systems and lighting. So as I mentioned, there are two new recognition categories for participants this year, integrated lighting and horticultural controls, which could be some integration with a grow facility that optimizes energy efficiency, but also could improve crop yield, reduce the amount of chemicals or pesticides used, or other non-energy benefits associated with horticultural grow facilities or controlled environment agriculture. The other new category is innovative maintenance operation and financing service models. This could include, you know, any innovative approach to funding these integrated lighting projects. A lot of people talk about lighting as a service, or maybe it's unique utility incentive models from electric utilities or any other kind of those alternative financing options. So again, those are our six categories for recognition for participants, and we'll get more into how to submit a little bit later. Next slide. So first I wanna kind of set some definitions here. I've been talking a lot about a few different groups of people here and participants and stakeholders. So let's cover a little bit of terminology just so we're all clear. So you've heard from the organizers and their role in the ILC. They provide the campaign with direction and support. Supporters are organizations that deliver some value to a building owner or end user, whether it's products, services, electricity, incentives, something else. They could be energy efficiency organizations with utilities. They could be manufacturers or ESCOs, that type of thing. Supporters really play a key role in our success by helping promote the ILC and identify projects that might be a good fit for recognition. And finally, participants of the ILC are the adopters. They're the actual boots on the ground adopters of the technology, like building owners, facility managers, anyone overseeing the use of technology in a building. And I hope there are a number of current or soon to be participants on this call. Next slide. On this slide, you'll see really only a partial collection of our campaign's supporters and participants. Supporters on the left side, participants on the right. Some of those on the supporter side might be organizations that you do business with, or you know, might get, you know, some of those incentives or information from. On the participant side, you might see an organization like yours. Or someone that's taken part in a research effort that has been conducted, or someone that, you know, received incentives for having adopted energy savings technology. Again, this is a partial list. A full list of supporters and participants is available on our website. We look forward to adding some of you to this list. Slide. So, as I mentioned, organizations like building owners, operators, managers, you all can join the ILC as participants, and I hope some of you will do so today. Once you do, you will have access to resources and technical assistance to help identify those innovative strategies to integrate your lighting with other building systems. Of course, you will also have the opportunity to gain recognition for your projects and your projects that use those connected lighting controls and or integrate with other building systems. So I really hope that there's at least one person on the call right now that's saying, I'm sold, I'm joining the integrated lighting campaign right now. I would say, great, go to our website, integratedlightingcampaign.energy.gov. You find the top of the menu where it says join. Once you're there, we'll ask you to provide a bit about yourself, contact information, some details about your organization and facility, maybe what sector you operate in, and your interests besides lighting, of course, like HVAC, plug loads, demand response, whether you're really interested in energy savings and that, you know, energy payback or some non-energy benefits or any combination of those. Slide. So maybe some of you aren't quite sold yet and need to hear some more about the benefits of the campaign. Well, you're in luck because I will tell you more. For starters, we provide a lot of technical assistance. You will have direct access to the expert lighting professionals here at the Pacific Northwest National Lab. And trust me, there are a lot of us here that like to talk shop, like to talk lighting. We can help answer your questions like, what use cases might make sense for your project or building, or are the products you're considering capable of meeting the project needs? We also collaborate with other national labs who have expertise in some of the other areas that I've talked about, like plug load professionals from NREL or the building envelope folks from Oak Ridge National Lab. And of course, we are here to help you join and submit projects to the ILC. Slide. There's also quite a bit of information exchange that happens with the ILC. If you join, your organization will be listed on our website with a link to your webpage. You can participate in webinars, discussion forums, and other events, really upping your exposure in the lighting industry. You'll be on the list to learn about new case studies or research that support systems integration or advanced lighting controls. You'll stay up to date with our newsletter. Overall, let us promote you. If you sign up, we'll tell you that, we'll tell most of the people that we know how great you are and how hard you're working to advance integrated lighting. That's the big piece of the recognition. Okay, next up. Sorry, next slide. And of course, when you join, you have the ability to get recognized. So here's how it works. You review the recognition categories. We already did that. We looked at those six categories, but you can always go to our website and refresh your memory. Then you submit your building or portfolio within that applicable category or more than one category. You can do that on your own or with our help. You can email me. I will be happy to walk you through that process. And then when the submission period ends this year on March 30th, the ILC team and the organizer committee review all of those submissions, and really we kind of debate and we choose the best and brightest for recognition this year. The recognitions are announced at an event in August. Fingers crossed it will be in person this year. Okay, next slide. Last but not least of the benefits, really, it's all the resources that we offer on our website. You can find database and lists of utility incentive programs. You can discover new research, learn about energy savings use cases that can help maximize the efforts in your building systems integration path. There are trainings and webinars that can be leveraged as staff training or continuing education for your facility employees or something like that. And finally, there are videos that help you keep up to date on technologies, up to date with our work and our partners' work. Okay, that was a lot of talking. Next slide, I'm gonna ask you to take another poll. There are so many ways to leverage the lighting system to attain additional benefits. Select all that apply to your organization. Is it systems integrations that lead to whole building energy savings, data acquisition or smart analytics, health and well-being for building participants, location-based services, or other. If you select other, feel free to use the question and answer pane to tell us more. Okay, let's go ahead and close that one. Okay, good results. Over half of you, systems integration that lead to the whole building energy savings, nice, but then a smattering of health and well-being, location-based services, and others. Again, for the person that selected other, feel free to let us know. It helps us improve the program and know what you're looking for. Okay, let's keep going. Okay, so I want to tell you a bit about last year's recognized participants and supporters. Starting with the participants, we recognized 13 organizations. You can see their logos here, ranging from higher ed to retail to healthcare facilities and government buildings. Four of the organizations were recognized for advanced controls and sensors, six for integration with HVAC, and two for integration with plug loads. And three for integrations with other building systems. In a minute, I will dive deeper into a couple of these, but I wanted to give you an overview of the 2021 recognized supporters. So this is kind of what it looked like. And as you can tell, these numbers add up to more than 13 organizations. So I want to reiterate that point that buildings or participants can be recognized in more than one category. Next slide, please. We also recognized seven supporters last year. That includes utilities, nonprofits, and energy efficiency organizations. Some of the aggregate stats from our supporters include 145,000 luminaires incentivized at over 300 projects, totaling almost $14 million in incentives, as well as 100 training courses and 100 tours given. So that's great. Right. So again, I told you I would tell you a little bit more about some of our recognitions last year. So to give you an idea of a couple case studies that have been published by the campaign. So a case study is something that we do for recognized participants to really tell the story and promote the project. So first up, I want to tell you about Bryan Health. This is a facility comprised of two healthcare campuses in Lincoln, Nebraska, totaling over 3 million square feet. Bryan Health upgraded their interior lighting from fluorescent LEDs with advanced controls, employing a comprehensive lighting management system equipped with occupancy sensors, task tuning, and preset lighting scenes. Also, they included the ability to kind of remotely control the system throughout the building with the dashboard really being able to provide a better level of control over their buildings. So not only did they get a serious boost in energy efficiency, they heard the staff were happier with their control over their lighting. They saw reduced support calls with shorter response times from the facility services, and better diagnostics to identify problems with the lighting before they were reported from occupants. Next slide. Another case study that was just published covered two exterior lighting upgrades, one at Massachusetts Port Authority, Massport, I mentioned a little bit earlier, and the city of Wilmington, Delaware. So starting with Massport, they upgraded 23 of their incumbent high-pressure sodium high-mast luminaires with LED, and they also integrated Wi-Fi into each of those poles that allowed them to better control the lighting and improve their operational efficiency and security. They saw 55% energy savings and a significant reduction in light pollution, and they really found that the residents of South Boston that lived near the port really saw an improvement in nighttime quality, really, with that reduction of light pollution. the city of Wilmington upgraded 1,700 of its streetlights to LEDs using photocells and wireless control nodes that provided them with an interactive dashboard for visualization of the exterior lighting and the street lighting status. So the city saw almost 70% in energy savings, as well as huge reductions in maintenance costs. And you can imagine that with that dashboard where they're able to visualize if they have a day burner, if they've got a light that has gone out, they can go out and go directly to that fixture and fix it. So they saw such a reduction in those maintenance costs that they found that they were no longer using one of their bucket trucks, and they're selling one of them just because it's not needed to kind of do that scheduled replacement of lamps anymore. So both of these projects had great energy savings as well as good non-energy benefits, like the Wi-Fi integration and reduction in light pollution. And that streamlined maintenance in Wilmington really made these projects a success. So again, they got the ROI payback for, you know, the saved energy, but it was those non-energy benefits that again kind of tipped the scale and really in favor and made these projects a success. Next slide. Our final poll of the webinar. So if you don't mind, one more poll. Have you recently completed any projects that leverages advanced lighting controls or systems integration that to attain larger organizational goals? Yes, we have a project to submit. We are working on one now. We are considering some work and would like to talk more about the technical expertise available. Or if we are finding building controls integration to be prohibitive in some way, I'll tell you about it in the chat or during Q&A. Okay, hope you've all had time to answer that one. Let's go ahead and close that. And again, feel free to use the questions pane to provide some more information. Nice, at least one of you have a project to submit. That's great. Also, some of you are working on something now, and a couple would like to talk more about considering some work. So great, please reach out to us. I have my contact information at the end of the slides. Be happy to hear from you. Okay, let's close that one and we will move on. All right, so by now I'm sure you're ready to submit a project, and here's how to do it. If you haven't been to our website, this is what it looks like. Click recognition in the top menu. That'll give you an option to submit for recognition or review some of those categories. You can also see join right to the right of recognition. You're welcome to join there too. Let's look at the next slide, as it is the form that you would fill out for recognition. Slide, please. Okay, so here's the start of the form. Some really basic information for you to fill out about yourself and the building, some contact information. You have the ability to submit on behalf of a project if you are not, don't fall into that category of participant, but I imagine that if you're attending this webinar, you may be the participant, so you leave that unchecked. You fill out just a little bit more information about the building. Is it a single building? Is it a whole portfolio? Do you have a name and the location? Okay, slide. So then you fill out what recognition category, one or more, that you're submitting to. Really, we have that first one, advanced use of sensors and controls. That's kind of a default. I have to select that one. But then if you have one or more integrated categories, you can click that down below. Slide. Okay, so once you select a category, then the fields open up and you can tell us a bit more. And this is the key part of the submission here. Really tell us the story of your project and how it fits into recognition, the recognition categories, And then you can provide some supporting data like the number of buildings impacted, measured energy savings, incentives received, any other quantifiable information that supports the narrative. So this is a pretty simple and streamlined submission process. If your project moves forward, we will work with you a little more closely one-on-one to learn about the project. So we'll have a call with you. We'll do kind of an interview style. But so this is the information that we need here to get the project started. And really, I want to stress it's a good narrative here, telling us the story of, you know, of the building. How did it start out? What did you start with? What made you want to upgrade the lighting? And what solutions did you take, and how did it improve the building? So again, good narrative. Don't leave out any of the juicy plot there. Okay, next slide. All right, I had this in an earlier slide in case you missed it. Here's the timeline for this year. Submissions are now open. We will accept them through the end of March. March 30th is our last day. We will review all the submissions. And when I say we, again, it's the ILC team here at PNNL, also our organizing committee. We review the submissions and again, kind of debate, and we kind of move them through a scoring process. And then we will inform the recognized participants of their selections, by June 30th. We'll announce the recognitions in August. Last year, it was the IES, the annual IES conference. Maybe that conference this year. I think we're still confirming that. It's still a little bit early, but we will definitely have that information to you soon. And then really what happens beyond recognition is where the campaign seeks to further add value beyond just recognizing these exemplary projects. It's creating this body of knowledge from the recognized project. So again, there's just basic information about each project and its benefits shared during the submission and recognition, but it's those more in-depth case studies like I showed you about Bryan Health and Massport and the city of Wilmington. Those case studies will be, you know, developed and will deliver more information to those considering similar products and systems. So if, say, you're a healthcare facility, you might want to look at that Bryan Health case study and really get an idea of what they did, and they might, you know, you might be able to borrow some inspiration. And then you really, that body of knowledge creates all the resources that we've been talking about today. So like newsletters, as well as those case studies or other information on our website. Okay, well, next slide. This is close to my last one. Those are all the content slides, so we can start with some Q&A. I'm gonna look over to the questions pane to see what's come in. If you have a question that you've been holding on to that you haven't entered into Zoom yet, now is a great time to enter that in. If you want to speak up, I think you can use the raise hand function. Otherwise, logistically, it's a little easier to enter a written question into the questions pane. But again, raise your hand if you want to speak up. I will take a look at that. I'm going to take a sip of water and see what has come in, and we can start to answer some questions. Okay. One that I see came in, does it cost anything to join or submit a project for recognition? No, it is a free program. I think Jeff mentioned this in his organizing committee spot, that the Better Buildings Initiative as a whole is a free program offered by the Department of Energy. And as part of the Better Buildings Initiative, the ILC is a free program. So the resources, the ability to join or submit a project.
Axel, there's a follow-up question related to that, is related to the technical support. Is that also, does that have a cost, any restrictions to it?
Oh, I think no monetary cost. I think the threshold that you have to pass is to join as a participant or as a partner. And again, that is free on the website. But once you do that, you will gain access to a lot of that technical support. You can email us at integratedlighting@pnnl.gov, and we can help you with some of that technical assistance as well.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And another one is about recognized sites. Kind of what do they get, and or how is their name and brand used?
Yeah, recognition comes in kind of a variety of forms. A good one is that those case studies that I mentioned, those are really circulated pretty widely. Not only the building name gets used there, but also the often the manufacturer of the products they used, or any kind of lighting design or consulting services they use can be named in there. So that's kind of a promotion and a boost for those companies. Again, if you go to our website, I think the top left menu item is partners, and you can click on that and go down to, you know, supporters or participants. You can see all of the names of our partners there that link to the website of their organization. So you can find organizations that are familiar with and support the program. If you submit for recognition and get recognized, really your name starts to come up in many DOE publications, newsletters, email blasts, social media posts. If you have a really great project, we will likely ask you to speak at some events like this and really help us tout the program to have people share your success story, that type of thing. Okay. That is all that I see.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay. This is a little complex. Give me a second to read it and digest it. Upper air UVC, which is ultraviolet C type, disinfected. Oh, does ultraviolet disinfectant included in the ILC? Do you have a design software for this technology, or can you tell us about a design? I feel there's a sentence, a word missing there, because there's a letter typed after it. So UVC disinfectant, and how is it done from a design point of view? So I'll leave that to you, Axel, for a second.
Okay, yeah. That is not something that we have talked about. I'm not aware of a design software or designs for those systems. I'm not the most familiar, but I know folks here at PNNL are working on GUV or disinfectant lighting, so we can definitely put you in touch. I would encourage you to send us an email, again, integratedlighting@pnnl.gov, and I think we can help you talk through that one. Okay, great, yep. Thanks for that question.
Yeah. Yeah, I think there's a couple of different complex things there. So yeah, that's good. Complex just in that UV is different than photopic lighting. Right. Those are the main questions at the moment.
Okay. All right. Well, again, this is not your last opportunity to ask questions or discuss with us. So let's go on to the next slide, and I will show you my contact information and contact information for the program. There we are, there's my digital business card there. You can get involved by going to our website, there's the link, or also the integrated lighting project-wide email is down there at the bottom. So please don't hesitate to reach out. And with that, I will thank you very much for your time today. Really appreciate you joining the call, participating in the discussion and Q&A. And I really look forward to some of you joining the ILC and submitting your great projects. So thank you. Have a great day.